We continue our conference, and the next speaker is Leon Takhtarjan, and he will talk about supersymmetric localization on Lie groups. So please, you can start.
Okay, thank you very much. It's a great pleasure to participate in this conference. So I know Andrei for many, many years, and it was really a great pleasure, and I really appreciate friendship with him. So the title of this talk is slightly different from the integrability topic of the conference, but if some of you may remember that long time ago, Andrei with Sushko, they were doing some Bose-Fermi correspondence for Sine-Gordon model, and he was studying fermions. So I think this may be of interest to him, this title. So let me discuss slowly then. So the introduction. So it's localization has several incarnations. One, the most natural one is finite dimensional case, where we have the famous Dustermann-Heckmann localization formula, which essentially says in a plain physics language that in some special cases, semi-classical approximation is exact. To be more precise, the formulation is the following. You consider compact symplectic manifold with circle action. And this circle action is Hamiltonian and has a global Hamiltonian function H. Then one can evaluate explicitly the integral of like classical partition function e to the negative t times the Hamiltonian over Liouville measure, and the integral localizes in a precise sense that it is the sum over critical points of the corresponding vector field or fixed points of the circle action. And here, if you assume that the circle action has only isolated fixed points on the manifold, then the integral is explicitly evaluated. And this is seems like a miracle because it's exact formula. And of course, you may ask how you can integrate, why it holds. Of course, the hidden thing here is that there is a circle action. And therefore, in particular, if you consider this Hamiltonian function, all trajectories will be periodic with the same period. So it's a very rare situation. For instance, this holds for oscillator. Then, and so it's really very rare, but beautiful formula, which was obtained around 82 or so. Was remarkable that this localization can be extended to the infinite dimensional case, namely for supersymmetric path integrals. And this will be our topic. So this was. So first, let me recast this localization formula in more using supersymmetry. So, well, I won't discuss it in details, but one can consider integral over the manifold over Liouville volume form as a canonical standard integral over the tangent bundle of a manifold. You just change the parity in the fibers in the tangent spaces. And then Liouville measure becomes standard canonical measure, dx, d theta, where theta are Grassmann coordinates in the tangent bundle. So basically you can see the tangent bundle with reverse parity in the fibers. And then this Dustermann-Heckmann integral can be written as the integral over tangent bundle over exponent, where you consider H Hamiltonian function as a even Grassmann variable. And then you have quadratic expression, omega mu nu theta mu theta nu is precisely the symplectic form in exponent. If you expand it into Taylor series, you pick up the top degree, which is precisely the Liouville measure, omega to the n over n factorial. So that's the Dustermann-Heckmann formula cast using supersymmetric variable. So it's just tautological read. But what's remarkable, and this was discovered by Witten and elucidated by Atiyah in a very clear way, is that this supersymmetric localization works for infinite dimensional case. And in particular, it gives the index of a Dirac operator, explicit expression in terms of the path integral. It's the old story, but I will review it very briefly because then it will bring us to the new story, which kind of extends localization principle dramatically. So let me first review what we discuss for Atiyah-Singer index formula. So you consider, as everybody does, compact oriented even dimensional spin manifold, Riemannian with a Riemannian metric. Then it carries a standard Dirac operator, which is associated to the Levi-Civita connection. It's a standard Dirac operator on a spin manifold. Then you write it in this form because the corresponding Hilbert space based on the spin bundle splits into positive and negative components, even an odd. And then the Dirac operator has this matrix form. And then the Makin-Singer formula says that the index of a chiral Dirac operator slash del plus is precisely the super trace of the partition function. Here H hat is a Laplace operator, just Dirac operator squared is a Hamiltonian. Then it acts in a Hilbert space, which is a direct sum of even and odd components. And super trace is a graded trace in this Hilbert space. And what's remarkable is that super trace doesn't depend on the temperature beta, and it's just invariant. So super trace is basically a topological invariant. So not something very specific and interesting dynamically, but still from topological point of view, it's extremely interesting. So that's what Makin-Singer formula. And then remarkable thing is that you can, which was discovered by Witten, is that you can consider the supersymmetric particle on the Riemannian manifold. And the action is the standard bosonic part, which is just the energy functional, and you add quadratic in fermions. And this is Euclidean action. So we're considering theory in Euclidean time. Instead of propagators, we discuss partition functions. So that's the Euclidean action. And then one can consider the corresponding, this action is supersymmetric. It's a standard supersymmetry, which mixes even and odd variables. So delta X is psi, the fermion, and delta psi is negative X dot. It's all along the loops in the manifold. So here it's called N equals 1/2 supersymmetry because we're considering Majorana fermions. They're real. There is an involution for fermions and they are fixed points of the involution. So the real they correspond to real Grassmann variables. That's important because this is the simplest case, slightly degenerate case of the supersymmetry. So we have this, then capital Q is the supercharge, the generator of the supersymmetry. The supersymmetry is given by the graded Poisson structure. And then this, the action can be obtained as a variation of the supersymmetric variation of the central charge, as it's here. And supercharge itself is, it's a classical supercharge, just psi mu canonical momentum p mu. And after quantization, it becomes Dirac operator. So quantum supercharge is a Dirac operator. Corresponding quantum Hamiltonian is q square. And then according to some general principles of quantum mechanics with fermion variables, that the super trace of the evolution operator, Euclidean evolution operator, is precisely the path integral of e to the negative action over all fields. And the integration goes over the loop space. You can see the periodic boundary conditions on bosonic variables X and periodic boundary conditions for fermions. This is extremely important. The super trace requires periodic boundary condition for fermions. That's why this path integral has a geometric interpretation. The domain of integration is tangent bundle to the loop space, like infinite dimensional manifold, and you reverse parity in the fibers. Of course, this is totally heuristic, but it can be made actually rigorous. There is a work by Bismuth and other people, which you can make it rigorous using Wiener measure, Malavian calculus, and so on, becomes very involved. But everything can be made rigorous if you want to. So that's the expression. And that's all what I am discussing until now. It's tautological. So just then the key fact, remarkable fact, is that since this path integral is supersymmetric, it localizes on the zeros of the vector field. Since we have supersymmetry transformation is obtained from the circle action, just S1 acts on the loop, on the loops by rotating each loop. Then the fixed points of the action are constant loops. And then these fixed points are no longer isolated, but that's not a big issue. One can still localize the path integral to the constant loops. That's what was proposed by Witten and Atiyah. And this was done. This is exactly like an infinite dimensional version of the Dustermann-Heckmann formula. Explicit computation was done by Luis Alvarez Gomez long time ago. And then remarkably, it gives that the path integral is precisely the integral of the A-hat genus of the spin manifold, which is exactly Atiyah-Zenger formula for the index of the chiral Dirac operator. So that's kind of derivation of the index formula using path integral. So that's the essence of a localization. When people talk about supersymmetric localization, this is the main example. Then, of course, this can be generalized, and it was generalized in many directions. For instance, you can consider not a quantum mechanics, just quantum mechanics, 0+1 field theory. You can consider supersymmetric sigma models in 2D. Then you can compute the index of Dirac operator on the loop space, and so on and so on. So it becomes very involved. But still, the main point is that we always compute the supertrace of the Euclidean evolution operator. But we know from statistical mechanics, from quantum mechanics, that partition function, which is the trace of the Euclidean evolution operator, is a much more fundamental object. Then the natural question is, can you compute the partition function? Can you compute the trace of corresponding supersymmetric theories and not only the supertrace? Of course, this is a very, you can see that this supertrace is very clever in a sense that if manifold is not spin, then the integral of the A genus given by some form is not an integer. So it kind of detects whether you have a spin structure on the manifold or not. But in fact, it computes only integers or some rational numbers, if you like. So how to compute traces? And then that's what I will describe very briefly. So it turns out that if you consider a general Riemannian manifold, even spin manifold, then you cannot compute the trace in the same framework of Atiyah and Witten. The manifold should be special, should have some symmetry properties. And these are precisely Lie groups, the homogeneous spaces, and possibly quotients by discrete groups. So these are the target manifolds on which there is a new supersymmetric localization principle, which allows to compute trace and not only the supertrace. This is a joint work with Chang-Ha Choi. He's a graduate student in the Young Institute for Theoretical Physics at Stony Brook. He finishes this year. And so I will try to describe it very on the simplest example. You see, the simplest example of localization is when the group is abelian, just the Lie group is U1, a circle. Then we know we can describe corresponding quantum particle on a circle. It's a free particle. And then we know the spectrum. We can compute the trace. And of course, the trace will be Jacobi theta function, the same. And then, so let's do it carefully, because that's the example I will do. And you, this can be done pretty easily. And then I will briefly mention how to generalize it. So you can see the free quantum particle on a circle. Then the Hamiltonian operator is just this, the free one, second derivative. Theta is the variable on a circle with periodic boundary conditions. Corresponding supercharge is just psi capital P, quantum P is a momentum, and psi is one Majorana fermion. You see, it's kind of subtle because Majorana fermions should exist in even number, because you need to have, and so, but this is odd, just one Majorana fermion. So psi square is one. Or psi, classically psi square is zero. Then the partition function is easily computed, as is written here. And this is precisely the Jacobi theta function. Here beta is inverse temperature, is a positive number, but you can extend it to tau, a variable in the upper half plane, in the Lobachevsky plane. And then it will be precisely Jacobi theta series, rather, theta series, which is a modular form of weight 1/2. So this partition function carries a remarkable transformation property discovered by Jacobi. And this transformation property is equivalent to Poisson summation formula. If you know Poisson summation formula, you can get Jacobi inversion formula. And conversely, from Jacobi inversion formula, you get Poisson summation formula. That's well known. So let's see. So that's the trace of the evolution operator. Now, what happens if we consider the, if we try to mimic a Atiyah-Witten discussion? Then we consider supersymmetric extension of the classical Euclidean action, which is x dot square, you add psi, psi dot, where psi is a Grassmann variable. Then corresponding path integral, the one you use for Atiyah-Zinger index formula, is trivially zero, because circle is not a spin manifold, it's n-dimensional. One dimensional rather. Then this integral is zero, which can be seen clearly from the path integral because it has fermion zero mode. Because if you consider everything is periodic, you expand in Fourier series, then there is a constant term, which is a zero mode. Path integral is obviously zero. But it's kind of interesting that here in this action, bosonic and fermion degrees of freedom decouple. So, and that's how you can show that total integral, naive integral, path integral is zero. Remember that in Atiyah-Witten approach, when you discuss the bosonic path integral, then Bose and Fermi modes are not decoupled because there is a Levi-Civita connection. Here, Levi-Civita connection is just a flat, just d by dt. So you can do integration by psi or integration by x separately. Now the key, and this splitting suggests the following trivial, actually, generalization. You can get the trace if you insert the zero mode into the path integral. So the logic is the following. If the path integral is zero, supersymmetric path integral for super trace. In other words, if the super trace is zero, you can insert the zero mode and turn it into the trace. So that's the key idea, very simple. So you can compute trace when the super trace is zero, like in this case. So supertest is zero. We insert fermion zero mode, just the integral divided by the T, capital T, I think is 2 pi times beta. And then this is a neat formula for the trace. Now, what about localization? So let's, what about localization? Then you see, if you in a Tia-Witten approach, everything localizes and it's generalization, everything localizes at constant loops, at fixed points of the circle action. Here we know in Poisson's, in Jacobi inversion formula, you shouldn't localize at the constant loops. Rather, you should localize at classical trajectories, at solutions of the classical equations of motion, which are very simple. X double dot is zero with periodicity gives you all maps with different winding numbers. And so now then, and this can be obtained by the following. So, and this is the statement of the simplest example of the new localization principle I was discussing. So you consider this path integral, and then the statement is, if you add to the action a supersymmetric deformation, where, sorry, here there is a typo in the action, should be negative S plus lambda delta V, where delta V is a supersymmetric variation. So you consider higher derivatives terms, this functional V, which is X double dot times psi dot, its delta of V is precisely X double dot square plus psi double dot. And then you can see this is delta V, and you insert this, replace V by delta V. I'm sorry, it's a typo. Then the key statement is that this path integral doesn't depend on lambda. When lambda is equal to zero, it gives the trace of the evolution operator. But now, as we can compute it by sending lambda to infinity. And when you send lambda to infinity, the term e to the negative lambda delta V will be dominant, and it will localize at precisely at solutions of classical equation of motion. So that's very rough idea, but why it doesn't move. And so that's how you get the Jacobi inversion formula. So let me just walk you through very briefly. So you start with the trace, then you write it in this form. Again, lambda times delta V, it's a type. You write it explicitly. Since we consider a loop space, everything is invariant under translation. You can reduce it to the based loop space, putting out the volume of the group, then the same path integral. Then fine, this is true for all lambda. Then you can pass to the limit lambda goes to infinity, and then everything becomes localizes at delta function at X double dot, and you compute certain infinite Pfeiffians or determinants, which is not simple. And then you get precisely this expression, the action localizes at classical trajectories, which gives you precisely Jacobi inversion formula. What's interesting, Jacobi inversion formula is a precise statement, so we need to have all coefficients correct. And they are correct and precise. Now, so that's the localization on the Lie group, sorry, on S1. So again, it looks like a simple exercise, and it is a very simple exercise. But the key idea is really strange, but works. If your super trace is not zero, if you have a meaningful index formula for the Dirac operator, you cannot compute the trace. Only when the index is zero, when the super trace is in fact a difference of the same quantities, so to say, then by differentiating somehow or inserting the zero mode, that you can turn zero into the trace. So that, and this is precisely how it works on the case of the S1. And so you see the key think is decoupling. So we consider on S1, the corresponding metric is flat, and Levi-Civita connection is just d by dt along the loop. And so everything can be decoupled, and you compute the Pfaffian of just the third of d cube where of t, where del t is a d by dt operator acting on real L2 Hilbert space of real valued functions with periodic boundary conditions, and you consider the Pfaffian. And all this can be computed quite by elementary means using zeta function regularization. In this example, everything uses only Riemann zeta function, so it's kind of funny. Now let's consider the general case. So let G be compact, connected, semi-simple Lie group. And then we would like to discuss the heat kernel on G. So this Lie group has a unique, has canonical B-invariant Riemannian metric, which is obtained from Killing form on the Lie algebra. Killing form is normalized, so everything is normalized somehow. And then, of course, this heat kernel is invariant under group action, and so it's sufficient to compute the heat kernel when from identity element on the group to some e to the maximal torus, to some element in the maximal torus, which is exponent of u lying in the Lie algebra of maximal torus. So then, of course, you start with classical action. You consider free quantum particle on the Lie group. So that's the action. J is the current. G inverse G dot. J is the map. G is the loop on G. Little g is a loop on G. Then, and this is kind of non-trivial, then you would like to do the supersymmetric extension of this standard bosonic action. There is a universal extension using Levi-Civita connection, but this is not good because corresponding path integral will be always zero. The index of a Dirac operator on the Lie group is zero. And Bose and Fermi degrees of freedom are not decoupled because Levi-Civita connection has curvature. But it's remarkable that on the Lie group, there are two different connections, which called plus and minus left or right invariant connections, which are flat. They are not, they preserve the B invariant metric, but they have torsion. But this torsion is Q symmetric, so corresponding equations of motions are the same. So corresponding extrema of the action functional are the same. And then one need to do this supersymmetric extension using this flat connection. And then corresponding Dirac operator will be not the Dirac operator discussed by of a Levi-Civita connection, but this type of a Dirac operator, which was well known, but not very much used in mathematics, is called constant Dirac operator. It was used, it contains a cubic term in Clifford generators. And this Dirac operator was used, Bismuth used it a lot. So writing the supercharge in this case is slightly non-trivial, you know, rather messy. That's why I am not writing. But what I'm saying is that it exists, you can write it down. And then you can compute the super trace of this Hamiltonian. Hamiltonian H is Q hat square. You can compute it using two methods. One, you use the Hilbert space interpretation. Then the heat kernel is given in terms of the characters of irreducible representations of G and the eigenvalues of Laplace operator. This is well known, obviously. But then the next stage is to add a supersymmetric, the next stage is to add the analog of this V, which we discussed for the circle, to add the, so let me go, oh, here, yeah, to add the analog of to add V, which is written below, which again, it contains J dot, which is second derivative of G, and psi dot. So this is higher derivative term. And then the key thing is that the super trace doesn't depend on lambda. Here it is correct, written correctly, negative S plus lambda delta V. It becomes rather involved if you write it down, becomes very complicated. But then one can compute the limit. Lambda goes to infinity. And then from here, you obtain the interpretation for formula for the heat kernel, a certain sum over the dual root lattice of Lie algebra G and some other terms. Remarkably, this is a formula obtained by a Soviet mathematician Eskin in 1963. He wrote this formula. I think he's really alive. You can find him on the Math Science Net. He obtained this formula. He published like 2-page report in Uspekhi, and his long paper was published in some proceedings of Kazan University in a volume dedicated to Chebatarev, and it's not translated into English. Neither of these papers are translated into English. And then, so this result was rediscovered later by several people. I think only Marinov and Terentyev mentioned Eskin's work, but this is his formula, and then of course this approach can be generalized to homogeneous spaces, which also interesting. And this is work in progress. I cannot say much on the quotients of homogeneous spaces by discrete subgroups. And so that's the very brief outline of this localization principle. So just to finish my talk, I like to say, дорогой Андрей, поздравляем тебя с юбилеем, очень рады и очень надеемся увидеть тебя в ближайшем будущем. Thank you.
Thank you, but nice. Nice time and nice place. Okay.
Right.
Thank you.
You remember this, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much. Please, we don't have time, but several short questions, maybe we can handle it. So please ask. Okay, if there are no questions, again, thank you very much.